authority by law to officiate at your marriage today. I have this opportunity to wish you both much happiness in your future lives together. James and Rachel, do you declare before mission, and yet, I'm sorry, that you are free by law to be married to each other today?
Yes.
Before you are joined in marriage, my presence and the presence of these witnesses, I am to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship and future now about. Marriage, according to law in Australia, is the union of a man and a woman to the exclusion of all others voluntarily entered into for life. Now, Andrew, please come forward.
Beyond words, she's very, very special to us, and we are so happy for her. So I just want to make sure you knew that you're very much a part of our family from here on in, and you're so old.
James and Rachel have chosen to exchange rings as an outward symbol of their commitment to each other. The band of the wedding ring represents everlasting love, the ring of never-ending circle with no beginning and no end. James, please place the ring on Rachel, the left hand. I get to say, Rachel, wear this ring with all my love.
Yeah.
You've been in the news, obviously.
everybody gone?
I'll tell you when.
We'll just do this.
No, just make it short, so.
Here we go. Looking at the camera.
Let me check.
Okay, ready? Yeah. Right, Craig's down, Rich. Meet me in everybody, make sure you see your front row to your bend the knees a little bit.
Do you want me to kneel?
Look happy, Jim.
Yeah, I can, because I'm in a very good. I'm like holding myself up.
Yeah,
you got it, right. Okay. Okay. So, it looked good. One person blinked on the last one. Yeah. Here we go, look at me. And we'll just do the usual click cheer one back. Yeah!
Yay!
Hollywood. Here we go.
Congratulations, Rachael and Jim. I think it's a fantastic wedding. And I love meeting all of them. Lovely events. And I'm having dinner with them, and they're going to come to Waiheke Island. And come and see us.
Focus has always been North Melbourne.
Come on, come on.
She wants a photo with your lovely lady.
Okay.
Distance to be here tonight, and I know Rachael and James appreciate that very much, so welcome to you. I really must say, I don't think I've seen my daughter looking as beautiful as she is. a bit of a ragtag tacker that's just been happy to get around in whatever is going, so she looks pretty special tonight. She's scrubbed up really well. Also, a warm welcome to James's parents, Jeff and Pam. Welcome to you. It's a bit of a shock to see this young lady who, as a little taker, was carted around on my arm, climbed under the car to help me fix the bloody exhaust. And generally believed just about anything she was told, particularly about budgies. We had a young budgie that sat on a cage in the kitchen. It managed to, one evening after the kids had gone to bed, the thing managed to work out how to get out of the cage and make an escape, which we thought was pretty impressive. The back door was sitting ajar, and as we chased this bird around the kitchen, it flew out the door. So we shot out the door after it, and here's the dog sitting there with a very, very surprised look on his face, and the tail of a budgie hanging out of his mouth. So we told him to spit it out, which he did, and we gathered the bird up. It looked to be okay, so we put it back in the cage, and it hopped back up on the perch, and it looked like it was none the worse for wear. Anyway, the next morning we came out and here's the bird flat on his back in the bottom of the cage with his legs in the air, dead as a doorknob. So we hit the cage very quickly, and after Rach had gone off to preschool, Anne shot down the street trying to find another bird. She wasn't able to find one exactly the same, but got one pretty close. And Rach has come home that evening and or after preschool, and she's noticed that the budgie looked a bit different. So, look, as a flash, I said, oh yeah, budgies change colour overnight, because so Rach didn't make any comment, but not long after, Anne was talking to Rach's preschool teacher, Miss Tuppy, who reckoned we had a pretty special bird, because Rach had gone off to preschool and told all and sundry that budgies do indeed change colour overnight. Talk about a Great Wall of China moment, eh? But anyway, that innocent little taker now is a grown-up woman and about to embark on her own journey into marriage and eventually motherhood. Might finally make me a legitimate grandfather, which would be a good thing. And I'll just say, Rach, marriage can be a wonderful thing, a great challenge, you and James have got a lot in common, and you've already done some of the hard yards that are required to make a marriage work, and if you keep doing that, keep looking out for each other, looking after each other, I'm pretty sure you're going to have a nice, wonderful life together. So, in finishing, I'd like to thank all those that have helped us put this together. It's been a bit of a drama, but yeah, we've got this far and we haven't got too much skin missing, so I think we've done not too bad a job. So, I didn't bring a glass with me, but I'd like you all to please be upstanding. To Rachael and James.
I'd just like to thank everyone for coming. This is definitely the most important day of my life. I'm the luckiest man alive, I think. The most beautiful bride I've ever seen. I don't have much to say, but just thank you very much. Thank you to Mike, Anne and Viv for their help. My parents for their help. Couldn't have done it without you. Emily, you've bent over backwards to make this happen. So, and Bernie. You've once again proved yourself invaluable, and Nancy and Kath for the cake. All the trouble we had, so thank you very much for getting that happen. That's about it. Enjoy the day, and yeah, thank you very much.
Good job, Ben.
Thanks,
mate. That was lovely, Jim. Thank you very much for that. We appreciate that very much. And now I'm going to call on the father of the room to join us. Jeff, under custody, as he is speaking in public, I don't think. We welcome Jeff in his affable style to come down and to say hello. And it looks as though he's got a bag of tricks with him too. Which we won't let the cat out of the bag at the moment. If you'll excuse me. There we go, Jeff.
Thank you very much, Pete. I'd just like to add my simple comments to what Mike said. Thank you very much for everybody turning up today. I know a lot of you have come a long, long way. A lot of country people here, and we even have friends that have come across the Tasman from New Zealand. So thank you. My job's quite a simple one. I just have to respond on behalf of the bridal party, which my daughter, obviously, is the beautiful lady in the blue. Well done, darling. Also, two beautiful flower girls here, absolutely magnificent. And we have three ushers here. Henry's really so, well done, boys. Thank you very much. There's a lot of work that goes on in the background to make something like this happen. My very good friend Bernard, who you probably all hate at the moment, but he has done a wonderful job. I'm sure I haven't seen the pictures yet, but I'm sure they're wonderful. And I just want to publicly thank you, mate. Thank you very much. We also have a wonderful MC, my wife's uncle, Pete. So where are you, Pete? I've got a little present for you. Thank you very, very much, Peter. And I'm not sure if he's listening, but Roger, are you in the kitchen, Rog?
Roger!
Yes, he's
in the kitchen.
You
don't
get
you, Roger.
Roger the Dodger.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Pam and my very good friend, Roger Mulet, who's obviously Swiss, because this is the Swiss one. And whenever we have a function, we generally come here, and he always does brilliant, absolutely brilliant job. So, Raj, I've got a little present for you if you'd like to come up here. That's it from me. I don't really have much else to say except I obviously have best wishes, as Mike said, to our new family member, Rachael, and welcome, you are, and my beautiful son. So, thank you very much.
And generosity, and to mine host here, fantastic job of these lovely girls.
Sarah and Monica.
Sarah and Monica. We watched the movie like Green's Lightning to serve all you hungry folk, and a magnificent job they're doing. Thank you so much, ladies. Folks, we're going to serve a very, very special dessert, and after that, we'll have more formalities, perhaps the happiest time when we introduce the cake and the cutting thereof. Enjoy your dessert. Thank you. Around there, so we get a nice shot. And those of you with a camera, now's the time, just before we do it, don't be shy, now's the time to get up and come down with the camera, so you get a nice shot if you want to. Emma, come on. Come on, push it along, Marcus. Come down now if you want to get a nice shot.
Come on, Rudy, fire up.
Of course, the wonderful tradition of cutting the cake. And now, folks, on a count of three from all of you, the cake will be cut. One, two, three. And now, as is the tradition, we have the bridal waltz. A special piece of music has been chosen by Rachael, who will now.
Ah, boys!
It's all right. It's okay. When I walk, I walk with you.
I loved it. You saved my day.
Going behind Wynn. Wynn, you're not wearing funny.
Thank you.